Day 2 of Top 5 Week continues with the top 5 moments of 2017. If you didn't see yesterday's videos, that would be the top 5 matches of 2017. Go ahead and check it out. It's going to be in my playlist category. Let's get right into the moments. The first one, which is going to be number 5, that's going to be any NXT debut or return slash call-up. I didn't want to make this list all returns and call-ups and all that kind of stuff because they are huge moments, and they kind of take over the whole entire top 5. Like, we have Nakamura, we have Shelton Benjamin making his debut again. A lot of people made their returns. Luke made their return to the Luke Harper made his return to the ring. Eric Rowan made his return to the ring. We had Sister Abigail make a debut. So, throughout the year, we've had a lot of call-ups, a lot of debuts, and easily any of those could have fell into the top 5, which is why I just put in his own category as number 5. Third moment of the year is the Shield reunion. This is something we've been wanting since the Shields broke up, and 2014 is when they had their official breakup. It's been 3 years, they've all gone on to be World Heavyweight Championship. Two of them are Grand Slam, both Dean and Roman. Seth still has not become a Grand Slam champion yet, he's only missing the IC belt. Throughout their time of being broken apart, we've all wanted them back together. Sure enough, they finally came back together, and that moment to hear the entrance of them walking down the stairs again, so great. Finally, you have that goosebumps back of the Shield making their return. So happy we finally have them back. Who knows for how long? Doesn't seem like they're going to be staying along for much longer, but hopefully they stay. Now, the last two moments did come from WrestleMania this year. WrestleMania brings the best moments of the entire year, even though it's at the very beginning. But you all know, Mania, it's the moment it's going to take place. So number 2, just beating out number 1, will be The Undertaker's retirement. During his match against Roman Reigns, we all kind of rumored that Undertaker was going to be retiring this year, but none of us really thought it was true. We all heard that Roman's going to beat Undertaker, and I truly believe that Roman was going to beat The Undertaker, and I know Undertaker had the mentality of, if you're going to leave your career, you have to go down on your back, which pretty much means that you put a new guy on top of where you used to be, giving your position up to try to boost them. Undertaker is very much into that respect and the older business standards, so I kind of figured he was going to lose to the young guy, but to see him take off his gloves and his coat and his hat into the ring and just leave, that's a moment that you're going to replay for years to come. It was really hard to finally see him end his career because you didn't want it to be over, but at the same time, you knew it had to be ending soon. And the number one moment of the year are the Hardy Boys making their return for the tag team belt at WrestleMania, turning it into a fatal four-way TLC match. It was something that we all wanted. We all wanted the Hardy Boys to return for years after Jeff left, and we just didn't see what was going to happen. They were huge in TNA, then they left TNA, and they went to ROH, and I'm like, you know what, they're not going to be in WWE for a very long time. The fact that they had a match at ROH Supercard of Honor pay-per-view the night before the Young Bucks for the title, and then they debuted at WrestleMania, it was insane. I didn't see it coming. You know, New Day come out, say there's a fourth person, and I'm all like, I don't know, it's just going to be a regular tag team. I'm thinking they're going to say they're in the match. When that music hit, I lost it. There's no way to not lose it the moment that music hit at WrestleMania. It was amazing. That was the best feel-good moment of the entire year. You know, it was really close putting Taker and the Hardy Boys next to each other, but the Hardy Boys' return edged out because it was such a shock, and the Undertaker's you kind of knew was going to be coming. So let me know what you think about my top moments of 2017 in the comment section below. Make sure to subscribe. I'm so close to 300.